Now that the announcement has been made, advocates for the return of the Balangiga bells say it's time to put the pressure on and follow through.
Come visit me when you come in.
Former Hollywood actor turned treasure hunter Logan Clark has been on a crusade to bring the bells home, launching a campaign and getting Hollywood stars involved in raising awareness. He's been lobbying lawmakers to help with the bells' return. This week, U.S. Defense Secretary James Mattis announced the department has notified Congress of its intent to return the bells, saying it is in the interest of national security.
He said they're coming back, and make everybody expect it to happen. It is now a foregone conclusion that they're bringing the bells back. Publicity needs to push them to give a date, give a deadline, because this administration has a lot of talk, but it doesn't walk very much.
Despite the development, some Wyoming lawmakers have opposed the return of the Balangiga bells. Congresswoman Liz Cheney, Senators Mike Enzi and John Barrasso issued a joint statement saying the bells are a memorial to American soldiers who lost their lives, and removing the bells would establish a dangerous precedent for the future of veteran memorials. Clark believes the Philippine government, including President Rodrigo Duterte, need to play an active role in the return.
The politicians, they should write letters to Mattis. They should thank him for, you know, bringing the bells back. When is he going to do it? Give him a date. You know, compliment him at the same time for doing it and being man enough to finally do it. That somebody finally stood up, and thank him for that. And now say, we need a date. A lot of people have talked about this. We need some action.
Clark adds that while the final date is being hammered out, the Philippines should also plan a grand celebration for when the bells return, making sure this issue is kept in the spotlight and the pressure for the U.S. government continues. Steve Angels, ABS-CBN News.